Hi, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for watching and for subscribing. And if you're just visiting, please consider subscribing. So, I just did a huge declutter on my channel and then I shared with you my newest haul. So, I think the next logical step is to share with you my wish list. And as it turns out, I actually haven't done any wish list videos this year yet, so this will be my first one. But I thought it made sense after declutter and haul to do wish list, and I did have a couple of requests to share on my wish list as well. So that's what I'm going to do today. Now, some of the fragrances on my wish list I have tried, I have sampled, and some I have not tried yet. I just kind of want to try them, and that's why they're on my wish list. So let's start with the first one. And of course, these are in no particular order. So the first one is Widian 2 from their Black Collection. Of course, I will be putting up pictures of all of these. Now, this one I have not tried. And to be honest, I haven't heard a lot about it either. But based on the notes that I have seen and some reviews that I read, I think this should be something up my alley. Now, this fragrance has plum, orange, sandalwood, rose, vanilla, musk, and moss. So really all of the notes that I like, from what I understand, it should be kind of a sweet vanilla scent with some plum undertones and maybe a little bit of rose added in. Again, all of the notes that I really like. The bottle itself is gorgeous as well. And I'm curious about this house in general. Haven't tried anything else from them yet. So that's why it is on the wish list. Now, I'm definitely not going to get it right now because I think it's the wrong season for it. But possibly when we're back in cold weather, I might get this one. Second on my list is a fragrance that I hear even less people talking about, and really I've had hard time finding any information about it, and I can't remember where I heard about it, but something about it kind of struck me and I kept thinking about it, and that's why it remained on my wish list. It is Leia Naima. Don't know if I'm pronouncing it correctly. Again, you can see a picture of the bottle here. So this has powdery notes, vanilla, cedar, oud, and musk. And I think if I remember correctly, what interested me in this scent is that, again, it's a vanilla scent from what I understand. And it is compared to, what is it called? Mercedes Black for Men, I think, a fragrance that I've raved about this year. It's a great kind of boozy, woody, vanilla scent. And from what I understand, this one is compared to it. So that's why I'm really curious to try it. Again, not right now for sure, but maybe when the weather cools down, I might get this one. Next on my list, I have a fragrance that is definitely suitable for warmer weather, and it's kind of a lighter citrusy scent, which I have been craving a lot this spring and summer. And as it turns out, I don't have a lot of those lighter citrusy scents. That's why this one ended up on my list. And it is from Atelier des Ors. It is called Blank Polychrome. So the notes in this one are lemon, orange, rhubarb, petitgrain, jasmine, lavender, fig, musk, ambroxan. You can see that this is a light citrusy scent, perfect for warm weather. I haven't tried it. There are a few things that kind of concern me about it. I don't like lavender. I'm not a huge fan of fig, so I don't know how prominent these two notes are in this fragrance. And the other thing that concerns me, of course, with these lighter scents, well, how is the performance? I want a scent to last. Even if it's on the lighter citrusy side, I still want it to last. So I'm wondering how this one behaves. So if any of you have experience with any of the scents that I'm talking about here, please let me know your thoughts. Tell me, do I need these? Do I not? How do they perform, etc.? Would love to hear your thoughts on all of these. So again, this one is on my wish list. Don't know if I'm actually going to pull the plug. I would love to sample it first if I have an opportunity, but we will see. Next on my list is a fragrance that I have sampled and I know that I love it. This is Moolah Moolah from Byron Parfums. And I mentioned already that I got a chance to sample the original Moolah Moolah and the Rouge Extreme. I loved both, loved Rouge Extreme just a touch more, and I purchased a full bottle thinking that I only need one of them, but surprise, I think I need the other one too. At least I want the other one as well. I want the original Moolah Moolah because I love Rouge Extreme so much. I feel like I need the original one as well. So I know that I love it. I know that I want it. I also know it is very pricey and perhaps it's kind of frivolous to have both versions. I don't know what I'm going to do with this one. We will see, but it is definitely strongly on my wish list. Next, I have a fragrance from Memo Paris. As you know, I've discovered this house earlier this year and I have been loving fragrances from this house. And so I want to try one more. I was hoping to sample it. Unfortunately, I haven't been able to find a sample of this one yet. This one is called Cadu. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing it correctly, but the notes in this one are grapefruit, neroli, orange, freesia, rose, peony, sesame, and white musk. And majority of these notes sound very, very appealing. And I think this would be a great scent again for this warm weather, except for one note that kind of scares me. And that's the note of sesame. I don't think I've ever experienced this note in fragrances. And from what I understand from all the reviews that I've read and I've seen is that this note is quite present in this scent. And I don't know what I think about this note because, like I said, I don't think I have any experience with it. So I'm hesitant to purchase a full bottle because, like I said, I just don't know if I'm going to like it. If I have a chance to get a sample, I definitely will because I am very curious about this scent. Next, I have a fragrance from YSL and this is called Atlas Garden. This one I had a chance to sample in a store and I really, really enjoyed. The notes in here are mandarin orange, neroli, orange blossom, bergamot, dates, tonka bean, ambroxan. This is kind of your fruity floral. I initially got very interested in this because it has the note of dates, which I really, really love. I can't say that I really detect that note in this fragrance. There are some kind of fruits in here. There are some kind of florals. There's definitely tonka bean and ambroxan in there, but nothing really stands out. The opening especially of this fragrance is gorgeous. The initial dry down stages are gorgeous. What I found in kind of the deeper dry down is that it started reminding me just slightly of Mugler Alien. I don't know why, but it sort of reminded me of that a little bit. Overall, I really like this scent. Like I said, the final stages kind of concern me a little bit. I don't know if I'm gonna love it long term. So we will see. Maybe this is something that I need to test a little bit further before I pull the plug. But overall, I really, really enjoyed this scent. Next one is a total surprise addition to my wish list because when this fragrance first came out, I thought, this is not for me. I'm gonna hate this one. I am talking about Bitter Peach from Tom Ford. I don't like peach in fragrance. And the way that this fragrance was described in many reviews, I thought for sure I was going to hate this scent. And then again, I had an opportunity to test it. And I wasn't even sure that I wanted to test it at first. And then I thought, okay, let me just spray it and see what I think. And I was totally surprised because I really, really like this scent. I'm not even going to go through all the notes. I don't have them here. I don't remember them, but definitely peach is the star player here, but it's kind of a slightly, I found the peach to be slightly sour and nicely surrounded by everything else, whatever that everything else is in this fragrance. I really, really enjoyed this scent. I was totally shocked. Now, I think that in general, Tom Ford fragrances are way overpriced, and I'm not willing to pay full price for this. But if I find it for a reasonable price, maybe for a significant discount, I think I'm definitely going to get it because, surprisingly, I really, really enjoyed the scent. Next on my list is a fragrance from a house that I'm completely unfamiliar with, but a house that I'm curious about. This is Diaz Durga. And the fragrance that I'm interested in is Rose Atlantic. Of course, you know, I love rose, and it's not like I need another rose scent, but I'm very curious about this one because based on the notes and reviews, this seems to be a kind of a very interesting and unique type of rose scent. So we have rose, lemon, bergamot, lime blossom, salt, grass, seawater, oak moss, and musk. So this is some kind of aquatic rose, it seems. I mean, there is seawater, there is salt, you know, there is grass, maybe it's a green rose as well. Like I said, haven't tried it. Very, very curious about it. Might pull the plug on this one, especially if I can find it for a reasonable price. I would say this is one of the fragrances that is very high on my wish list. Next, I have a fragrance from another house that intrigues me a lot. This is from the house of Maison Violette. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it correctly. I've heard a lot about this house, and I wanted to sample these fragrances. When I looked at the notes, none of them seemed like Save Blind buys for me. Just note breakdowns didn't seem like my type of notes, and I definitely knew that I needed to sample these. I had an opportunity to purchase sample set of these, and I tried them. And I can't say that overall this house is my cup of tea. Not exactly, but at the same time, all of the fragrances are very lovely, kind of soft, sophisticated, elegant scents. That's what I found. They're all quite light. They're not strong. They're not in your face. They don't project a lot. They're more of a skin scent, I would say, but lovely scents at the same time. Now, there was one standout scent for me, and that's Tanagra. So the notes in this one are tangerine, pear, freesia, iris, peony, jasmine, cedar, vetiver, and musk. And it's kind of a fruity floral with really beautiful freshness. I really like the fresh aspects of this fragrance, and I don't know what exactly brings this freshness. I would say maybe freesia, maybe tangerine. It's freshness, it's zestiness, it's even maybe slight watery nuances. I'm not sure how to explain it. It's such a round scent where none of the notes really stand out a lot. And in fact, that's what I found with all of the scents from this house that I tested. They're all beautifully blended. I mean, they're high quality scents, even if they're not exactly my cup of tea, but I can appreciate the masterful creation of these scents. They're beautifully blended. They're really gorgeous scents. And this one is really my favorite from the group. So I'm interested in it. Not sure if I'm ready to pull the plug because these are, again, quite pricey. And like I said, these are quieter skin type of scents, at least on me. So we will see. But like I said, this was my standout from this house that I tried. Next on my wish list, I have a fragrance from Carolina Herrera private line, and it is called Burning Rose. Yes, another rose. What can I say? I love roses. This one I have not tried, but I'm very curious about it. You know, I have one fragrance from this private collection, Nightfall Patchouli, I think it's called. And, you know, I'm curious to try something else from this line. I looked at a number of different fragrances, but I think that out of everything, Burning Rose interests me the most. The notes that are listed, and I'm not sure if they're accurate, we have rose, cinnamon, ginger, patchouli. I mean, sounds like rose patchouli with some, you know, sweet, spicy cinnamon. Sounds right up my alley. Don't know much about it, haven't tried it, but definitely very curious to try it. Next on my list, I have a fragrance from Quinto Canto, and it is called, no idea how to pronounce it. I'm gonna say Ricnina, no idea. But you will see the name in the bottle on the screen. Now, the reason that this fragrance piqued my interest is because it is being compared to Fleur Narcotique from Ex Nihilo, as you know, a fragrance that I've had on my wish list for a very, very long time, but it is extremely pricey. And from what I hear, it doesn't have the best performance. And this one is said to be quite similar, but with much better performance. And I'm hoping maybe better price point. Now, the notes in here are peach, bergamot, orange, plum, peony, iris, orange blossom, jasmine, oud, sandalwood, patchouli, oak moss. Okay, a lot of notes. No idea if it is really similar to Fleur Narcotique, but, you know, reviews seem to suggest that. So I'm curious about it. Not sure if I'm going to get it or if I'm going to get the original. I don't know, but it is definitely on the wish list. And we have two more fragrances left. Let's go with the next one. This is a new release from Amouage called Material. Now, haven't had a chance to try it. And I know that Amouage fragrances are very, very risky blind buys. At least for me, I find their fragrances very complex, often strange, often unwearable, very risky. But what interests me about this one is two things. One, this seems to be a vanilla scent, which, you know, we all know I love. And second thing, it is created by Cécile Zarokian, which is probably my absolute favorite perfumer. I love her creations. So many of her creations are just absolutely amazing and are definitely at the top of my collection. And so these two things make me very, very interested in this scent. So the notes are patchouli, LME, vanilla, benzoin, tonka, incense, oud, osmanthus, labdanum. Seems like this should be a winner. I don't know. I haven't seen it available anywhere yet. Really hope that I get a chance to sample it first. Like I said, I'm scared to purchase Amouage blindly, but we will see, but definitely this one is pretty high on my wish list as well. And that brings us to the last one, which is a fragrance from a new to me house as well. This is from Healy. I was very curious about this house and ordered some samples as well. Was quite impressed with a lot of the samples. There are quite a few that I really, really liked. But again, there was one real standout for me, and this is Note de Yuzu, I think. Now, this one is about yuzu, grapefruit, mandarin, orange, sea salt, seaweed, musk, vetiver. When I looked at the notes prior to smelling it, I was kind of afraid that this might be a bit too masculine, but it is not at all. It is definitely unisex. And it's a really interesting fragrance. I mean, yuzu and grapefruit are definitely strong here. I would say this is a grapefruit scent. But you also have these kind of aquatic sea notes. You have sea salt, seaweed, and they bring that kind of sea breeze, the fresh air feel to this combined with this grapefruit. Grapefruit is not very sweet. It is zesty. It is a little bit tart. It's a really interesting spin on grapefruit. And I've mentioned before that grapefruit is my favorite citrus note. So overall, a really, really interesting kind of unique grapefruit scent. I really like the sample. I'm considering purchasing a full bottle. Haven't pulled the plug yet, but we will see. So that's it. That's the end of my wish list for now. I will be honest with you. I have not ordered yet a single thing from this wish list. As you know, I am trying to stick to my low buy. But these are the fragrances that I'm interested in at the moment. Would love to know what is on your wish list right now. Maybe you have some good recommendations for me that I need to add to my wish list. Not that I need to add anything else, but Anyways, please recommend, share with me what you have on your wish list. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please remember to give me thumbs up and subscribe, and I will see you soon in my next video. Bye!